during this trip, I've learned a lot more about the political process. I'm not a poli sci major, so it helped me understand the process more.
Making things greener, campuses smarter about their technology, and
a new Democratic majority, obviously you're in a different party. How do you see the government changing? Where do you see it going?
Well, I think there's, I feel, a lot of optimism in the air. I mean, yes, it's change, and from a Republican's perspective, we would have preferred Republican change, but we got Democrat change.
If you're going to debate the issue of energy, then you debate all issues. Mm-hmm. Now, it doesn't mean that all end up on the platter, mm-hmm. but the way it's been done is piecemeal, and I think it's an inappropriate way to develop policy. Mm-hmm.
So here we are standing at the Lincoln Memorial, which is getting ready for an incredible concert featuring some of the most influential African-American and white artists of our day, all celebrating the inauguration of our nation's first African-American president at the location of Martin Luther King's historic I Have a Dream speech 40 years ago.
If there's one thing I've noticed about DC and that I've been impressed about, it's the security that the entities, this United States Secret Service, the Capitol Police, and police from Virginia have been doing to promote safety for all the people that are here.
We want everybody to go this way, all right?
Right, go right.
Oh, we're going.
Oh, they're gonna follow us.
Hi. I am in Washington, D.C., welcoming the next president of the United States with a delegation of 10 other students from our university, an option that was made available to us through UAF, an incredible option that hopefully you, in 4 years, will also be able to take part in. I'd like to welcome you to UAF from Washington, D.C., as today I'm welcoming the president of the United States along with thousands of millions of other people, and it's really a great opportunity.
Don't worry about it, man. Look, you can look into it, Todd.
The New York Center would be the last.
Wow.
For the three of us right now, we're just kind of hanging out and waiting for some action, waiting for some chance, waiting for Obama to appear, give a speech.
Yeah, baby!
Alaska!
Go Alaska!
Alaska!
Absolutely amazing. There were about millions of people there, and right now we don't know how many, but it was really neat. We stood there with six UAF students, and we stood among all these people, and they screamed, and I had shivers go down my spine when Obama spoke, and it was really magical, the entire thing, and it was really just wonderful.